Good afternoon, everyone. The entire central west of New South Wales has been hit very hard in the last 24 hours with flash flooding. Places like Canoundra have received falls of up to 120 mils in the 24 hours to 9 a.m. this morning. The areas of concern are Parkes, Forbes, Eugowra, Molong, Cowra, Canoundra, Blaney, Young, Yass, many, many communities across the central west, the west and the southern parts of New South Wales. We have 9 major flood warnings in place current across New South Wales. Of the 107 warnings currently in place, 16 are at emergency warning level, including at Canoundra, Derrawong and Cowra, where residents have been urged to evacuate immediately. And at Eugowra and Molong, people have been urged to move to higher ground. In the 7 hours between midnight and 5 a.m, we've had 140 flood rescues in Eugowra alone. More than 100 of these were rescues from a roof. This means, with a population of 700, more than 1 in 5 residents have been rescued in the last few hours by either helicopter or by boat. This is a very serious situation, not just in Eugowra, but in many places, particularly along the Lachlan River. The ground is so saturated that all it takes is one heavy downpour to cause the type of life-threatening flash flooding that we have experienced overnight and into today. Downstream of Canoundra and Eugowra is the communities of Goolagong, Forbes and Condobolin. These communities are understandably very anxious about what the next few days are going to bring and how it will hamper their recovery efforts, which have only just really started to begin, and where places like Condobolin remain isolated at this time. We have had helicopters operating right throughout the day, whether conducting those all-important life-saving rescues in places like Eugowra, or whether it's related to the resupply of isolated properties and communities. Our emergency services organisations, their personnel and their assets are in full swing today to support our communities and, of course, to save lives. We currently have over 70 local government areas in New South Wales that have a natural disaster declaration in place. This event is now in its 62nd day, and every day it throws up new challenges for our communities and for our emergency services personnel and organisations. We have our base camp, of course, set up at Parkes. It has over 100 emergency services personnel able to assist right up and down the central west as the floodwaters recede, and we need to get in and do those all important rapid damage assessments so that people can get back into their homes and businesses. I can also confirm this afternoon that we are welcoming 12 flood rescue operators from New Zealand, and they will touch down in Sydney tonight and they'll be heading straight to Parkes tomorrow to support the SES and our other emergency services personnel on the ground. The SES is now also working with authorities in Singapore and the United States of America to secure additional support. To conclude my remarks this afternoon before I go to Commissioner Carlene York of the SES, followed by Steve Bernasconi of the Bureau of Meteorology for their updates, I would like to urge the community to continue to work with us through what is proving to be a very, very challenging time. The last 24 hours have been very difficult indeed, and for those people that have been awake since midnight or thereafter with the rain pouring down right through that central west area, my heart goes out to you. I understand how difficult these times are, particularly those properties and those communities who have experienced repeated flooding where we are now expecting to see a third peak in as many weeks come down, especially through that Lachlan area. I'd also like to pay tribute and say thank you to our emergency services volunteers from whichever organisation you're in, whether it's the SES, the RFS, Fire Rescue, the Volunteer Rescue Association, Marine Rescue. Thank you so much for all of your efforts. I know it's been a very long night and a very, very big day. I know you're tired and we will get through this. And I want you to know that on behalf of all of the people of New South Wales, we are very, very grateful to you and to your service. On that note, I'll hand over to Carlene York from the SES.
Thanks, Minister. So, thank you. So, overnight, we've been responding to this significant weather event in the areas that the Minister's mentioned. We've had 470 requests for assistance since 5 a.m. this morning, and as said, we've had 173 flood rescues. The weather is a result of severe thunderstorms that the Bureau have been predicting for some days now, and we've seen the results of that severe weather event coming across from the western part of our state, moving its way east. It's really important that we acknowledge all the agencies, as the Minister said again, in what they've done over the last 24 hours in these areas around Parkes, Forbes, Yugara, and other locations. It's been a substantial effort by all agencies. Not only did we pre-position some resources around these small communities, but we have sent in urgently more resources to help those communities at their time of need. We've done a large number of flood rescues from roofs. We've activated the ADF nighttime winching helicopter last night to assist us, and we've had 12 helicopters in the air during the day to help those community members get to safety. We've got a number of warnings out at the moment, and 16 of those are emergency warnings to evacuate now, and I would ask people to heed that warning. We can see how quickly the waters can rise, how quickly flash flooding happens, and the devastation it causes across not only homes but businesses and farmlands across these areas that we've got the warning. And again, I would ask those residents and businesses to evacuate when we ask you to evacuate. Because it becomes very dangerous for us to send our volunteers and other emergency service partners in those areas when you have realised the danger that you are in and the danger that you're placing your family in by not evacuating when we tell you to evacuate. Certainly around these locations too, there are many roads that are cut and many roads that are dangerous because of the water over those roads. We've seen over the last couple of months with these continuous rain events, the surface of the roads is severely damaged as well. And when you come across water across the road, you're unable to see the damage underneath the water and you're unable to assess the risk appropriately for you to make that decision. So if you see water across the road, turn around and find another route and don't travel around these areas because it is dangerous at the moment. The water will take some time to go down, and we will ensure that we try and get in and do those rapid damage assessments as soon as possible, but when it's safe to do so, and we will allow those residents that have evacuated to go back into those areas. So certainly the river systems that the Bureau, Steve from the Bureau will talk about in a moment, around the Menagerie Creek, Lachlan River and Barwon and Darling Rivers are what we are looking at as a priority at the moment. We want you to stay up to date with those warnings. It's really important if you can have a battery operated transistor. We know that there are a number of power outages and we've been talking with the energy providers in relation to trying to restore those powers, power back to those communities. But again, please be patient. Those technicians in their vehicles have to travel over these same roads, so they can't go across flooded roads. So as soon as they can get in safely to these areas, they will be able to get the power back and running for those communities. So if you need assistance, I'll just remind you that to ring SES, New South Wales SES on 132 500, and if it's an emergency and life-threatening, ring 000. We're working very closely with the police out there as well as all our other partner agencies. There's substantial resources across these areas of the community that need them, and we will respond to those requests for assistance as soon as possible. But again, make sensible decisions, know your risk, and don't overestimate your ability to get through these floodwaters and place yourselves in danger.